Amelia, you want to ask her what she's doing, what she's working on?
I'm making a basket. You might need a basket to work in the garden.
Amelia, you want to ask her what she's doing, what she's working on?
I'm making a basket. You might need a basket to work in the garden.
Do you actually use the kiln across the way?
Over there. We fire it once a year in the second week of September during the crafts weekend. It'll take like 5-6 cords of wood. It'll take, we'll fit 850,000 pieces in there in 30-40 hours long.
Wow.
So it's quite a big deal.
And then I'm boiling up some vegetables and very soon I'm going to make something like oils right in your vegetables. You need it for your boiled dinner. And it comes out like a big dumpling. So you could slice it with dinner and put your curry right on it.
Cows every day, so.
And you know, like we're talking a little bit of compliment.
Thank you.
Sure, thanks for coming.
Certain work. There's tons of different hammers out there, and I have just been fascinated with hammers since I started making them, so we'll see. Maybe I'll make a whole page of different hammers, and I'll just make this page and showcase them all over time. But making that smallest hammer, it'll be a lot easier with the bigger, slightly bigger every time.
Yeah.
Bass Lancashire. So this is a slightly more expensive hammer than the common riveting hammers that you can also get. So if you wanted that fancier hammer, and I don't know why you need it, but if this is the cheap model, it does the same thing as that, but it just doesn't look as nice. Why would you ever want this piece of junk? Of course that's gonna work better. The rivet's gonna just love that. It's gonna say, oh yeah, that's the one. You hit me with that. So depending on what you can afford, you're just buying the one that's the most affordable and as nice as you can.